wake too early in the morning. Sing you a song that I wrote with the help of a wonderful friend and a great man, a man called Pete Seeger from New York. And Pete Seeger is 91 years old. He's still playing music. In fact, we played with him just a few weeks ago at the Great Pumpkin Festival of Beacon, New York. And we had a big birthday celebration for Pete last year, Madison Square Garden, for his 90th birthday. And Pete was singing, playing, and lots of very dear friends of his and wonderful people playing as well. And we were invited over to play, and we were delighted. People like John Baez and Arlo Guthrie and McGarrigle sisters. Wonderful people from all over the place. But there were a lot of very big names there as well, and it was a little bit nerve-wracking. The MC was a man called Tim Robbins, who's an actor. And he came in to tell us when we were on. He said, "You're on immediately after Kris Kristofferson and just before Bruce Springsteen." it's one of those nights. But Pete, I'm sure people would be familiar with Pete Seeger here.
Yep.
Yes. He's written some beautiful songs like Where Have All the Flowers Gone, Find a Hammer, and so many others. In fact, one of the very first songs I ever heard him sing was with a group called the Weavers, before they were put off the radio because of McCarthyism in the United States. Maybe you remember this one. Irene, goodnight, Irene. Irene, goodnight.
Remember it?
Goodnight, Irene. Goodnight, Irene. I'd see you in my dreams. A Saturday night, I get married. Me and my wife settled down. Since then, there's been some confusion. I think I'll take a stroll downtown. See you this time. Had in the charts way back in the late 50s, early 60s. So this is a song that we wrote together, and Pete Seeger lives in a small log cabin in the high banks of the Hudson River. And anytime we go to the United States, we always try to meet up with him. And very often we're talking about old songs or thinking about new ones. We're talking about how sometimes music can heal conflicts, not only between two people, but between the conflicts in one's own head. And I remember I said to Pete, you know, someone should write a song about that. Pete said, you write. So I came back a few months later and I sang a song I'd written. And he stood up all 6'2" of himself and he looked out through the window of the house below and he said, it's good, but it's too short. It needs another verse. I said, you write. Which he did. And we recorded this song together. It's called Music of Healing.
Strong girl,
follow its footprints, singing goes.